Hello, and welcome to this video on the overview of meshing process using Ansys Fluent Meshing Watertight Workflow. In this video, we will look at the bird's eye view of the process of converting a CAD model to a CFD simulation ready mesh using the Watertight Workflow in Ansys Fluent. We will learn how to launch a Fluent Meshing session, select the workflow, and go through its different tasks to create a computational mesh that can be passed on to the fluid flow solver. Along the way, we will also learn about few items related to the workflow interface, such as tasks, task states, and more. So, let's get started. Let's start with launching a new session of Fluent Meshing. Start Fluent to open the launcher menu. Here, we can select meshing to enter the meshing mode. As you can see, meshing is only available for three-dimensional geometries. You can select whether to run in double precision, which is the recommended setting, and whether to display the mesh after reading the file. Over here, you can input the number of processes to be used to enable parallel meshing and accelerate the meshing process. We will use 4 for our example. Now, press Start. This is the Fluent Meshing interface. In this video, we will focus only on the left side of the UI. The drop-down menu in the Workflow tab lets you choose between watertight geometry, fault-tolerant meshing, or creating a new workflow. Select watertight geometry. The buttons on the top right of the panel let us load a saved workflow, save the current workflow as a template, reset the entire workflow, or access the online help guide. Let us now briefly understand the various steps involved in creating a volume mesh using Ansys Fluent Watertight Workflow. The meshing process can be broadly categorized into 4 major steps: importing the geometry, setting the mesh sizes and creating the surface mesh, describing the geometry and creating the regions like solids or fluids, and finally, setting up and generating the volume mesh. Let's go through this workflow with a simple example. Click on the Import Geometry task to access its input panel. Keep the default values for the file format and units, and click on the 3 dots next to the file name entry to locate and load the geometry file into the workflow. For demonstration of this workflow, we will use a simple cylindrical pipe model. Our aim is to create a volume mesh for this geometry, which can be used to simulate a fluid flow through the cylindrical pipe. Once the geometry is imported, you can notice that the import geometry task is now marked by a green check mark. This indicates that the task has been completed, while the yellow lightning with an exclamation mark next to the remaining tasks indicate that these tasks have not been completed yet. These icons are referred to as the task states. In addition to the green check mark and the yellow lightning symbol, there are 2 other task states. A green check mark with an asterisk referring to a task that is completed but with warnings for the user to review, and a red triangle with an exclamation mark referring to a task that requires further attention. The next task is to set up the local sizing settings for creating the surface mesh. In this example, we will not be adding any local sizing. Therefore, let's leave the choice to no under the Add Local Sizing task and press Update. In the input panel of the Generate Surface Mesh task, change the minimum size to 1 mm. Leave the rest at default and select Generate the Surface Mesh. Once the task is completed, a tessellated mesh representation of the cylindrical pipe, generally referred to as the surface mesh, is created. The next step is to describe the computational model, which is done in the Describe Geometry task. Because the geometry we imported represents the fluid flow region inside the cylindrical pipe, we will select the option, the geometry consists of only fluid regions with no voids. Leave the rest to default and press Describe Geometry. In the next task, that is, Update Boundaries, we can specify the boundary conditions that we would like to apply to the model. The boundary surfaces have already been named during the CAD creation stage, which is the recommended approach. Based on these names, Fluent Meshing tries to automatically assign appropriate boundary conditions. Like you see here, the wall surface has been assigned the wall boundary condition type. Let us set face 1 to pressure outlet and face 2 to velocity inlet and press update boundaries. Once a task is updated and is executed successfully without warnings or errors, all the task's input options and controls are disabled. If you need to make any changes to the inputs of a completed task, for example, say you wanted to have the flow moving inside the tube in the opposite direction, we need to flip the boundary conditions applied on phase 1 and phase 2. For this, you can use the revert and edit button in the task's input panel, perform the necessary changes, in this case, assign velocity inlet to phase 1 and pressure outlet to phase 2, and hit the update button to re-execute the task. Notice how the task's state changed from green check mark to the yellow lightning symbol, indicating an incomplete task after hitting the revert and edit button, and then back to the green check mark when the update button is selected. Some tasks give you the option to edit instead of just revert and edit. This is merely a cosmetic aspect to differentiate between tasks where user selection of zones or labels was done, for which revert and edit button is displayed, and those tasks where only numerical inputs were provided, for which just the edit button is displayed. Note that you can edit any of the tasks in the workflow and not just the last performed task. However, all the tasks downstream of the task being modified will also have to be updated, whether or not any changes were made to their settings. Back to our workflow, in the next task, which is the Update Regions task, simply press Update Regions since we have only one fluid region. Next, we need to choose whether we want to create boundary layer mesh for our model or not. In this example, we won't add any boundary layer treatment, so select No under Add Boundary Layers and press the button below to move forward in the workflow. In the last task, we need to provide inputs to generate the volume mesh. Select Fill with Poly Hex Core, keep the other default values, and press Generate the volume mesh. In a matter of seconds, we obtain a high-quality mosaic-type mesh for our model. That completes the meshing process, and you now have a volume mesh which you can pass on to Fluent Solver to perform CFD simulations. In addition to the tasks that are displayed by default in the workflow, you can access additional tasks and task-specific context menu by right-clicking on any of the tasks. Here, not only do you get the options to group, rename, or delete the selected task, but also the option to insert and execute additional tasks. Note that the contents of the Insert Next Task option are dynamic and change through the workflow based on which task you perform the right-click on. For example, the task specific context menu for the generate the volume mesh task gives you the option to add new tasks like extrude or transform the mesh, which are not available anywhere else in the workflow. Before we wrap up this video, let's quickly discuss about a few settings which can come in handy, especially in situations where editing of completed tasks is needed to be done frequently. These settings can be accessed by going to File Preferences and selecting Meshing Workflow. The Save Task Editing Data with Mesh File option is turned on by default. This option is to ensure that workflow-specific task editing data is saved when you save the mesh file. The data will be saved in a corresponding folder in the same location as where you have saved the mesh file. When this option is enabled, the saving data for editing tasks will be automatically set to write mesh files. This option instructs Fluent to save a mesh file whenever a completed mesh-related task is edited and is the recommended selection to re-access the data in future sessions. If this option is turned off, there are three options for saving the data for editing tasks setting. In addition to write mesh files, there is write into memory, which saves mesh file information to the system memory while editing tasks, and do not save data that does not save a mesh file when editing a task. If do not save data is selected and you need to edit a completed task, all the upstream tasks up to the selected task will be reprocessed. This can be time-taking, especially for large, complex models. Other options here allow us to change the location of temporary files folder or turn on verbosity, which instructs Fluent to print task-related messages to the console window. The option task-based display controls how Fluent displays task-specific items of the model in the graphics window based on the threshold values set for automatic display phase zone limit and automatic display facet limit. This can be useful when displaying large models. Let's summarize what we learned. We have seen how to start a Fluent meshing session and select Watertight meshing workflow. We explored the overall look of the Watertight workflow and its different tasks. We discussed about different task states and their meaning, and also explored additional settings to customize the workflow behavior. That brings us to the end of this video.